There's so much to learn, so much to explore. From the surface of the water to the ocean floor, it's Porky's Ocean Patrol. Yes, Porky's Ocean Patrol.
Ahoy, my friends. Welcome to Porky's Ocean Patrol, a show with me, Porky, and my friends Georgie, Kaurna, and you, my ocean patrollers. Together, we'll discover all about our great southern reef, the wonderful sea creatures that call it home, and how we can all keep our oceans happy and healthy.
Ahoy, Porky! Where can you find the biggest cuttlefish in the world?
Buckle up, Georgia. I'm diving into this one head first. These magnificent creatures rule the cuttlefish kingdom, and they make the southern waters of Australia their salty playground. They splash around in the shallow reefs along our coast, showing off their 8 arms and 2 feeding tentacles. They're not fish at all. They're part of the cephalopod crew. Like the squid and octopus, they are squishy. Millions of years ago, their shell was on their inside. Now, here's the juicy part. These cuttlefish are masters of disguise, changing their skin's colour and texture, like underwater chameleons. Plus, they've got 3 hearts and blue blood. Talk about unique. The party's just getting started. Between May and August, thousands of these cuttlefish gather in Whyalla. Yep, right here in South Australia, for the biggest mating event in the world. Witness this underwater magic up close. Grab your snorkel or dive gear and head to Cuttlefish Coast, around Point Lowly and Stony Point, every July. And here's a little secret. You might spot them in water less than a metre deep. But remember, they are protected in these waters. So don't touch or take. Just watch and enjoy their majestic beauty. The ocean, known as sea country, is an important part of Aboriginal culture, and we all play an important role caring for the sea. My friend Kaurna can help us learn more about Aboriginal culture. Ninamani, Lily.
Ninamani, Porky and Kaurna. How did you make fire so long ago with no lighters or matches?
Ooh, what a cool question. Kano's got the scoop on exactly how it's done.
Well, thanks, Porky. You know, back in the day, you're right, we didn't have any fancy lighters or matches like today. We had special other materials like flint or our amazing fire sticks known as the Karla Koro. So, the fire sticks are like a magic wand, but cooler. Imagine 2 sticks from the yucca bush. Here, I'll show you exactly how it's done. The wider piece gets a small notch and hole. Then it sits on the ground. The other piece, long and thin, goes between your palms and you spin it super fast between your hands. The spinning creates friction, like rubbing your hands to keep warm, but way, way hotter.
What's happening now, Kaurna?
That friction heats things up so much that it creates an amber glow. Porky, this amber is like a tiny fire starter, and boom, we have fire.
It's like magic from nature.
Oh, there's another way, using flint and pyrites, but we saved that trick for South Australia where flint was around. We use fire to cook, tell stories, keep warm, and even in ceremonies and medicine.
But hey kids, remember, always have a grown-up with you if you're trying this out. Safety first. Ooh, Kaurna, looks like one of the ocean patrollers has a question.
Ahoy, Porky, how much rubbish ends up in our oceans each year?
Bravo, Stefan. All right, let's dive into this one together, Georgie.
So, here's the scoop, kids. You won't believe it, but it's estimated a massive 12 million tons of plastic enters our oceans every year. Can you imagine that much plastic?
It's like filling up thousands and thousands of swimming pools with plastic junk.
Porky's right. And you know what's even more surprising? Around 80% of this rubbish comes from everyday stuff on land that gets washed down the river or the drain. The rest, around 20%, comes from things like fishing and shipping. Sometimes, even wind and animals can carry rubbish to the beach, and then it gets washed away into the ocean by the waves.
And here's the thing, it's not just the big stuff. Even tiny pieces of plastic can be super harmful to our marine friends. Seabirds, turtles, whales, dolphins, they all get affected by plastic pollution. It's a big plastic problem for everyone under the sea.
We can all help though, say no to single-use plastics, use eco-friendly and reusable alternatives, and always pick up litter whenever you see it.
So, ocean patrollers, let's make a pact to protect our seas and make them plastic-free. Who's with us? How many hearts does a giant cuttlefish have? A. 3. B. 13. C. 33. D. 0. The answer is A. 3 hearts. What should you do when you see litter on the beach? A. Leave it. B. Play with it. C. Pick it up, put it in the correct bin. The answer is C. Pick it up, put it in the correct bin. Guess what time it is, Ocean Patrollers? It's Porky's Activity Time. Head over to my website for this week's activity to download. You can become a Porky's Ocean Patroller too and protect our wonderful sea creatures and their homes by taking your very own Porky's Ocean Pledge. Find the special POP Pledge certificate with the link I've put in the description. Thanks for watching. It's been swell. See you next time.
Porky's Ocean Patrol.